I think we should be very careful about both, not so much direct protectionism as much as indirect protectionism. And I think we're very aware of them. Our government is very aware of them. And I think we're going to fight that back, because who would know better about how protectionism is bad? We know it, right? We have suffered it all 3 or 4 decades post our independence. So at this point, the impact that happens is that people don't want to be very open, customers, about the optics of a new outsourcing and offshoring. They need us more than ever before. Their budgets are cut, but not the activities. So they have to do more with less. And who's going to be providing that solution? I think we are part of the solution. And I think they're getting it.
But right now you're saying that they're apprehensive of obviously saying that they want to do more offshoring.
Absolutely.
Work.
Absolutely.
And that they're holding back. What has your own experience been with existing clients?
While new clients or new potentials are concerned about some of the optics that come out of this, existing clients who are already in the business and have had the experience of successfully offshoring their work find that this is a great opportunity for them to move the needle. And I say this because we have found in our company, in EXL, we focus a lot on the insurance companies, and we do business with over 18 of them. The amount of volume that we now see from these companies has more or less doubled in the last year or so.
Really? In
yes,
this period?
Yes, it has. And I say that because, and again, it's not immediate, because there's a time lag between where they are and where they will end up. But there is certainly a growth pattern that we are seeing here, that despite all the rhetoric, despite all the concerns, and yes, there are job issues, but they are restructuring there where they're not necessarily laying off people. They're restructuring it in a certain fashion where experienced people are being retained. They may not be replaced as attrition takes place there, but they are certainly looking at us to provide the value that they require in terms, both in terms of cost savings, but also productivity and efficiency.
Let's talk about the new clients that could potentially come in. How much of a period of a lag do you see before actual new contracts come in? I mean, you know, everybody talks about a trough being formed and then a possible pickup. What is your own assessment of that?
The pipeline is actually pretty good, I suspect, for most of us. You know, there are lots of inquiries, lots of clients coming in. The time it's taking to go to contract is taking longer. So earlier it may have been 6 months, now it's 9 months. The time it takes to transition and actually have the work happen, et cetera, is also taking longer, because it's being done perhaps a little more sensitively or with a lot more due diligence happening on both sides. And therefore there are delays. And therefore the issue is not, is there demand? The issue is timing of that demand. If I may use that word.
You know, Pramod, the day you took over as the Nasscom head, I asked you how you see this industry growing. At that time, you conveniently said, well, I'm not going to talk about that right now, so I'm going to ask you that. After a tough year like this, what's the growth trajectory that you're seeing?
I think, you know, this year growth is clearly going to be low, single digits, somewhere like that for the industry as a whole. I think we are in the process of recalibrating the numbers for 2 years out. So clearly it'll have some impact on that. This year I think it's going to be single digits to flat. I think if you look at hiring, that's even, you know, we've been to the government, and this is in relationship to the STPI issues and the SEZ issues we've talked to them about. You know, at one time the industry was hiring 300,000 people a year. Today it's the tens of thousands. So it's a big change that's happening across the industry. Will it come back? Absolutely. No doubts about it. When and how, we've all talked about, you know, at what the timing of that is. So, but right now the industry is having to sit back and recalibrate and think about what it's going to do next. What you're going to see as a result, though, I think, is interesting business models coming up. You're going to see acquisitions, because companies are going to chase down acquisitions to make up for with inorganic growth what they may not be able to do in organic growth. And you're going to look, I think you're going to see expansion into lots of new areas by lots of different companies.